Let's go over one last chapter today, which is citing sources in your speech. I talked about that a little bit before when I was going over supporting materials for your speech, but let's get into it a little bit more. So, citing sources in your speech, alerting the audience to the sources you use and offering ones that they will find authoritative is a critical aspect of delivering a presentation when you credit your speech sources. You also increase the odds of your audience members that will believe in your message, demonstrate the quality and range of your research to listeners, demonstrate that reliable sources support your position. A big one, avoiding that plagiarism. There's different types of plagiarism. Also, enhance your own authority by demanding how your own ideas fit into the larger intellectual conversation about the topic. That's what I was talking about. Learning as much as you can about that topic, so when you're giving your speech, you're well-versed in the subject matter. And your audience, you're going to build credibility that way for your speech. That ethos, right? So you're going to build that credibility for your speech, and your audience is going to believe you more. Believe what you're saying more. And then they're going to give you credit, and they're going to say, this is one smart cookie, right? This one's one smart fellow, because they know what they're talking about. They have researched their information, and they've done it well. And you can cite that information as you're speaking. The author and the year that you found the information was put together. So you want to be able to do that, to build that credibility and avoid that plagiarism. There's a global plagiarism where you just copy a whole paper, right? And you don't think people can tell when you do that? Of course they can. Patchwork plagiarism, where you take bits and pieces of information and you put it together. And that is going to make you look like you don't know what you're talking about, because they're going to say, well, where did you get this information from? And you're going to have to tell them. One time there was this, I'm looking something else up. I was working at this one place, and there was this young man that was presenting. He was giving a presentation to the big boss, and it's important that you know where you get your information from. And so it's really bad. So he was giving his presentation, and the boss asked him, where did you get that information from? And he said, from one of my sources. And he said, from which source? And he couldn't tell him what source he got it from. So that really damaged his credibility with that boss. And so what the boss did was, he said, okay. And he was mad. At the time, the boss was actually... He was actually enrolled in college, working on his master's. So I can imagine the papers that he was writing and how important it was for him to cite all of his information in those different papers. And also, he needed more help with public speaking. So he became a member of Toastmasters. And they emphasize also that you need to cite your sources as well when you're giving presentations. So he made it very clear he wanted to know this, where this guy got his source. And I, the minute I heard him say, okay, well, thank you, I knew that something was up. So this guy had his own office before. Within the following week, he was moved to a cubicle against a wall by himself. This is how upset the boss got. And so he moved him to that cubicle, and he kept him there for a couple of weeks so he could think about what he did. And then he fired him. He let him go. That's how upset the boss got. So you can see how important it is to know what it is you're talking about and where you got that information from. Because if you don't, and somebody that of authority questions it, the information, or wants to know where you got it from, you better be able to tell them where you got it from. It's that important. People think, oh, you know, nowadays you can just copy and paste stuff and get away with it. You think, oh, you know what, that's really good information, I'm just going to copy it all and paste it in. Okay, you can't do that. You're stealing information from other people, and it doesn't belong to you, and that's unethical, and that hurts your credibility. So make sure that you do, when you do borrow information from others, make sure that you do give credit to where credit is due. All right, there was a little slideshow here on different types of plagiarism. There's global plagiarism, presenting an entire text, paraphrasing plagiarism, rephrasing someone else's ideas without citing them. So you're taking their words and then you're rephrasing them, but you're paraphrasing them but you're not giving them credit. Verbatim, directly copying a passage of text without a citation. Mosaic plagiarism, combining texts and ideas from different sources without citation. Oh, this sounds good. Oh, this is really sounds good. I'm going to put those two together. Self-plagiarism, reusing passages and ideas from your own previously submitted work. And then you don't even say in my previous research, so-and-so said this. Right? Incorrect citation, failing to give all the necessary information in your source citation. Whatever information you need to include is like the order that it appears on, say, a bibliography or a reference page. That's how you cite the information in your speech. So you give as much information as you need to, the name of the author, the year that the information was published, also, or the name of a periodical and the name of the article and when it came out. So you need to have enough information so that if an audience member wants to research that information further, they find it interesting and they want to, you know, or they just want to see, you know, go into more detail with the information that you've presented, then they can go in and see it, because you've provided them with enough information that they can go in and they can find it. So it's important that you do that, or otherwise you're going to get yourself in trouble like that young man did. So it says, an oral citation credits the source of the speech material that is derived from other people's ideas. For each source, plan on briefly alerting the audience to the following: the author or origin of the source, the type of the source, is it a book, a journal, whatever, the title or description of the source, in the book so-and-so, in this particular book, it says here, in the book Endangering Minds, blah, 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 by this person in 2010, she says that, and then date the source, the article published in the October 10th, 2018 issue of the Smithsonian. Here it says, or according to a report on choosing a college major posted online September the 28th, 2018 on the Chronicle of Higher Education website, Dr. Smith said that. You see? So that is enough information for me or for anyone else, anybody else, to be able to go back and say, yes, you know, I can research it more. Because I found your speech very interesting. Okay. Of course, spoken citations need not include complete references, exact titles, full names of the authors, volume, and page numbers. No, you don't have to include the page numbers or the volumes. Doing so will interrupt the flow of this of the presentation and distract listeners. So just enough information so that they can track where it is that the information came from. Establish the source's trustworthiness. Focus on presenting your sources in a way that will encourage audience members to process and believe in the source material. It says, too often inexperienced speakers credit their sources in bare bones fashion, offering a citation and of citation elements that doesn't have enough information. So you leave out key details of being able to track that source. So the source credibility refers to our level of trust in a source's credential and track record for providing accurate information. If you were to come up with a topic and you went to the library, even the virtual library that I have a link for in the course, you would find that there are basic books about different topics or more advanced books in the particular topic that you're talking about. And if in your readings you'll see other research also cited as well, and you can even say that information too. But if you go to the back of the book, you'll see all of the different contributors for the particular chapters, and that's a good way to find out more credible sources for your speeches. So you want to be able to do that to have accurate and credible sources. It says here, qualify the source. A simple and straightforward way to demonstrate a source's trustworthiness is to include a brief description of the source's qualifications to address the topic. It's called a source qualifier, along with your oral citation. For example, researcher at Duke Cancer Institute, a columnist for the Economics. This will allow your audience to put the source in perspective. So where does this person work? Why do they have so much credibility? Who are they? Okay, if you have a doctor in front of your name, then that's a pretty good indication that that person is a credible source. All right, so it says avoid mechanical area. Vary the wording when you have those embedded or interwoven in-text citations, okay? So in other words, you're using direct quotes and paraphrases from the sources that you've gotten your information from, and you want to vary the source, vary the wording of how you interweave those direct quotes and paraphrasing into your outline. And then when you practice it, You'll when you have your outline done that way, constructed that way with those in-text citations, and then you're going to have, when you practice it, you'll remember more about what those citations were, so that when you're actually presenting, you'll be able to remember them better. So it says avoid a root delivery of sources by varying your wording. if you introduce one source with the phrase according to, you can switch over to as reported by. You can use that as explained by as well. So you can vary those that wording. And there's another attachment to the chapter that you can look at different ways to cite in that speech. That's in the informative chapter, in chapter 11 or chapter 22. Then it says, vary the order in which you introduce a citation. Occasionally discuss the findings first before citing the source. For example, you might state that caffeine can cause actual intoxication and provide evidence to back up this claim before revealing your source. A chief source for this argument is a report in the July 15, 2018 issue of the New England Journal of Medicine. I've always been taught that you say the source first, but you can vary it up by saying the important phrase first and then citing the information. So vary that order. So there are many different types of sources and sample oral citations. You have books, you have reference work. And there's different examples in your book showing how to state them and to put them in your outline. According to the journal, newspaper, and magazine. So you've got to word it correctly according to that order that it comes out in your bibliography. So in the article with the information that comes out in that bibliography. So here's an example of a journal, a newspaper, a magazine. In the article titled The False Promise of DNA Testing, published in the June 2016 edition of the Atlantic Monthly Magazine, journalist and New York Times contributing writer Matthew Scherer argues that forensic testing is becoming even less reliable. So you can see the importance of how you word it so that you get the information out correctly. There's websites and blogs and television or radio programs, online videos. If you go to the OWL of Purdue, that's an excellent site, and it has a lot of information about how to put together an outline, how to do in-text cites, how to write a bibliography, for instance. Don't get a bibliography confused with a citations page. In MLA style and or APA style, a bibliography is a bibliography. It's written in alphabetical order by author, not by different type of sources of information, but by the author. So it goes alphabetically, and you're going to need that. And so as you're doing your research, and make sure for your main points, make sure that you're writing down where you got the information from. Write down everything: the author, the publication, title of the article, the year it was published, everything, the publishing house, everything that you need for that bibliography is what you need to write down. So that not only do you need it for your bibliography, but if you've done that outline and you go to rehearse it and you're thinking about it, or you're going back, you've let it rest for a day or two, and you go back and you go, you know, I need to address that question, so let me go back to my source. Oh, geez, I didn't write down that information. I didn't write down the source. So now you're going to have to go back and think, where did I find this information from? That's why you have to keep track of your sources as well. Not only to cite them in your speech, but to be able to go back if need be and find more information about what it was that you had written to answer a question that is in the back of your mind and is certainly going to be in the back of your audience's mind. So do your research and write it down and do it correctly. so that you can put it in your outline correctly. So that's the end of this part of putting together speeches, citing sources in your speech. So we'll look at other topics later related to building your speech, but that's all for this chapter. Thank you for listening. Bye-bye.